Welcome back to NetSuite Super Trading. In the last video, I introduced you to the Employee Center. In this video, I'm going to show you specifically how to log your hours in the timesheet. So let's take a look. Okay, you can see we're back on the Employee Center dashboard. Now, if we go down here, I added this recent records with my timesheet, so I can click on that. I can also just go to time tracking here and click on weekly timesheet. So let's click on that. And I click on it here. Okay, so this is the current week I'm in. So I currently don't have anything logged in my timesheet. So let's give an example and just kind of goes through some of the basic things. So it has the employee name here. You've got the date over here. You can look at, you can just kind of switch it to specific dates. You can also go back, you can click this little calendar button, go back to an entirely different week. And you've got the main thing here is the actual lines that show what hours you're doing. So let's, in this case, we're doing it as if we're a consultancy company. So if you are obviously a completely different organization, your dashboard will be set up and the options given to you to log your hours might be completely different than what I see here. I'm gonna be looking at kind of different clients that I can log hours to, but you might not have clients at all. It might just be like time off, holidays, sales calls. You know, it might have completely different entries. But let's take a look at this. First off, we get the customer or project. So let's say I did some work with Comito Controls. So I did some consulting for them. So this is case, task, or event. So I did, I worked on this case 11, doing some consulting for them, and that is consulting work. So I'm gonna put consulting services in the service item. I've got this billable column. I can check or uncheck that. In this case, it was consulting, so that is billable to Comito Controls. And the department, in this case, that's professional services rendered. All right, and you'll see you've got this little bar at the bottom here. It's hiding a couple additional columns you're gonna need to fill in. So we've got class here. So let's fill that out. In this case, I'm gonna put consulting and project management. And location, this all occurred, let's say in Seattle. So I'm gonna put that down. I don't need to fill in billing class here. Activity code is also not needed, but now I can fill in my hours. So for Monday, I did 8 hours, let's say, of data migration for Comito Controls. So I'm clicking in the 8 hours and then this little plus sign, which will be down there, will click in, fill in the memo, which is required for any kind of entry. So just to note what you were doing those hours on. So I put in those 8 hours, I move my bar back over here. So I've got that full entry in and now I can hit save. And it gives me a confirmation that I successfully saved that timesheet. So you'll see a little green box. I've got those 8 hours logged. Now for most of you, you don't just have one thing you're working on. So you can go, let's return to edit. And you can just start adding lines. So this kind of auto added, but let's say I remove that. So I've got my one line and I can go add a row and I can type in the next thing, right? Let's say I now did consulting work for MyBuzz. And again, I would just move through the line and I would add all these things for anything that I'm working on. So let's say Comito Controls, I did 4 hours of data migration and then 4 hours of a totally different activity. What you can do is if you click on this here, let's first just delete this guy. You can click on this line and you can actually hit duplicate. All right, so you have this duplicate here. And the reason is instead of having to put in all this information twice, I can simply hit that duplicate and I have the same information in there. So let's say I wanna change this so that it's only 4 hours of data migration and then I did 4 hours of consulting. So I click over here and I make that 4 hours. Again, I click the bottom right and I click that to let's say service call consulting. And I've now got, and you'll see it adds up automatically at the top that it's 8 hours, 4 here and 4 here, both for Comito Controls. And then it totals them up here for the week. I'm now at 8 hours. So that's a duplicate. All right, now let's try one additional example. Let's get rid of these. And so we have a blank slate. Now let's say we do the exact same function from week to week or the same activities and breakdown of hours, or at least it's a baseline that we wanna go off of. We can copy a previous week over to this week. And you simply go over here to copy from week, click on that. You choose the week that you're copying from. And as you can see, it now automatically fills in all the hours you had from the previous week, but in this week. So 8 hours of consulting for Comito on Monday, Tuesday, and then 2 hours on Wednesday. Then for Smith Supplies, I did some training, some user acceptance training. So I have a different memo for that, user acceptance training. For 6 hours on Wednesday, so it's still a total of 8 hours on Wednesday. And then 8 hours on Thursday, nothing with Comito controls. And then on Friday, I did 7 hours with Smith Supplies, and then 1 hour a professional service, like a sales call that I worked on with Semper Corp. So that's 1 hour for Friday. So all of these are totaled on the right, and they are totaled in the columns above, all totaling up to 40 hours for that week. So again, this was taken from last week. Now the odds that you're gonna have an exact duplicate of consulting hours from week to week is unlikely, but certainly if you're doing certain basic functions, you might have total identical from week to week and you can use that function. Okay, so let's say this is correct and we want to now save that. Go over to save. All right, and that's it for recording your weekly hours in the timesheet. I'll see you in the next video.